set up a follow-up email sequence. Oh my God, this thing does not stop chirping. So you want to build an email list and get people to subscribe. If you want people to actually read and open what you have to say, then you're gonna wanna sound professional and not sound spammy. I'm gonna show you how to set this up on autopilot so you can grow your email list while you sleep. It's like having an employee work for you behind the scenes. We're gonna be using MailChimp to set this up because they offer a free service for the first 2,000 or so subscribers. So it gives you a chance to kind of test out the software before you have to pay for any of the larger services once your email list starts to grow. You can set up a new welcome email for new subscribers, or you can set up an automated email marketing campaign to go out after a customer buys from you or to warm them up to buy at a later date. Maybe you might send the email out, say 7 days after a customer purchases from you to get feedback for a survey as well. I'm gonna show you both of these. Let's get started. Part one, setting up an email list and welcome message.
Log into MailChimp and select list. You're going to want to create a list. And this is what your subscribers will see. We're just gonna call it How to Bake a Cake with Brandi so I know what it is. The default from address, so we're just gonna use the domain one. So I'm gonna fill this in, and after I've filled this in, I'm just gonna hit save. Now, if you want to create a signup form within MailChimp, you just, once you're in your list, you can, I'll show you back up. So once you have your list created, you can set up a signup form. So you're just gonna select how to bake a cake. So that's the one we created. You can hit sign up forms. And you can either do a general form, an embedded form, subscriber pop-up. You can do any of these, but we're just gonna do a general form because this is gonna allow you a landing page. So this shows you what it looks like. You can leave it like this, or you can choose whatever color you want the background. So if you want it red, you can turn it to any color you want. And you can put a logo up top if you want to choose a logo. Select insert. Save and insert image. So we're just gonna put this in here so you can see. And then this will be like the title area, and I can just put how to bake a cake cheat sheet. And this is gonna be your sign up form, so you can put whatever you want in here. This is just a basic form. So you're just setting this up and giving them something saying, okay, download below. And you can take out whatever you want. If you wanna delete something from here, you can hit delete and delete it. Or you can add stuff to it if you have text, a number, more information. Now keep in mind, the more information you ask for, the less likely people are going to sign up for your list. So you just create your sign up form. You're going to do the same thing with your alerts, and you can change. This one is the same, it just has alerts on it, but your opt-in confirmation email, it's already pre-done for you, so you can leave it as is or you can change it. If you want to send a download, I do this in the final welcome email. So you'd select send a final welcome email, and in here you'd give them the download and say, you know, here is your how to bake a cake cheat sheet. And so I would link this to whatever your download is. So it's going to be a file, and I don't have that one in here, but I have another one, so I'm just going to show you from a file that I already have in here. But let's see what this one is. I have no idea, so I'm just going to insert it. Sure. So let's open the link and see what's in there. Your following. So this looks like a Twitter. This looks like my Twitter download. So I'm just going to download it so you can see what it is. So this is my Twitter guide, and you can go through this. So this is the download that they'll get in the email, and I'll save that and close. So after they've gone through all the prompts, this is what they'll get, and it'll say your subscription's been confirmed. Here's your how to bake a cake cheat sheet. So they can download it. Now, you can put this in the confirmation thank you page if you want as well. You can also send them to another URL instead of the confirmation thank you page. So I have blog posts that I send people to, so I actually put the URL in here so they won't ever see this page. If you save it, they'll just go straight to that URL. It can also go to a video if you're sending them to a video tutorial. It just depends what you want to send them to. So this is how to set up an email list and welcome message. So with this option, you have essentially a sign up form, so you can send people to this page with this URL and they're going to sign up, and I'll show you exactly what that looks like. So when they go to this URL, they're going to see this and they can sign up. So you can use this as a sign up form. It's just, you can kind of decorate it how you want. You're just really limited.
Part two, setting up an automated email sequence.
So you're going to go to campaigns, create a campaign, create an email. We're going to do automated, and you can choose how you want to do it, but this will say, what if we want to thank first-time customers? So we are going to thank first-time customers and thank you for your purchase, tell us about your purchase, and recommend a product. So this is a template that it looks like MailChimp already has set up. You're just going to go in and edit the triggers. So you can set this up to go out an hour after thanking them for their purchase, and it tells you what it's doing. It says when a subscriber purchases any product from your store, you can change this trigger to be something else. But we're going to leave it as is. You can also choose the schedule if you don't want it to go out on certain days, because maybe people don't open their emails on certain days. It just tells you that it may take longer to trigger the email, but I would probably not send it out every day. It just depends on what you're doing. If you're trying to get somebody to buy something, or if you're thanking somebody, it depends. If you're trying to get them to take an action, you may want them to subscribe or take action on, say, Monday through Friday when they're at work and they really don't have anything else to do. So this is kind of a pre-done email, and it looks like it says, hey, tell us about your purchase. So it's trying to get feedback from them, and you can set this up. This says 10 days after, and then 20 days after it says, hey, we'd like to recommend some products to you. So this is already pre-done for you, and you can set this up for every person that purchases from you. And it's going to send out. And then you can send a test email so you can see. So you can send a test email, you can send all three, you can send a specific one, just picking which one, and it tells you. So like, I would send it to myself and then make sure of what it looks like. You can also include a message in here as well. And then save and exit to set it up. So you can also take out one of these if you don't want it in here. But that's how you set up an automated sequence.
So now you know how to set up an email list and start building it with an autoresponder, but do you know how to actually get customers to join your list? No problem. I've got you covered with a checklist that will help you build the perfect opt-in offer that customers will actually want to sign up for and share. Click the link in the description below to download it now. I'm Brandi of blogginbrandi.com, where you can find tons of free resources to help you brand your business. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.